God says to Moses, "You have found favor in my sight, and I know you by name." He also says, "I will make all my goodness pass before you and will proclaim before you my name, the Lord." The Lord, that's what we would pronounce Jehovah or Yehovah. They call each other by name. Isaiah 43:1 says, "But now thus says the Lord, who created you, O Jacob, he formed you, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine." God knows you. He is your father. He knows the number of hairs on your head. He knows your motivations. He knows the plans he has for you. Moses and the Lord speak to each other face to face as friends. The people are in mourning in Exodus 33 because God says he won't be with them. They don't have that relationship. God's not abandoning them. He doesn't think he should be with them, or they might disobey his commands and his justice would demand wrath against the sin. He's afraid they'd be destroyed if he goes with them. Moses knows God's compassion and mercy too and convinces him to send his presence with them. Moses knows he and the people of Israel are nothing without God's presence. God being with them is what makes them who they are. The people recognize the special relationship Moses has with God. They honor their meeting together and they worship the Lord when his glory cloud descends to talk with Moses. There's only one besides Moses who has moved past the fear of the Lord, the beginning of understanding of who God is, into relationship with God, into intimacy, into being in his presence and getting to know him and knowing you are loved by him. Joshua has gotten to go with Moses to the tent of meeting. When Moses leaves, Joshua hangs around. He has come to know the sweet fellowship with the Lord. Is your fellowship with the Lord sweet? Do you linger just to be in his presence?